Just now, when our secretary was telling us that we have a 7,000 or odd kilometers coastline, our honorable minister from Tamil Nadu was telling me that out of which 1,000 kilometers is only with Tamil Nadu, and there are something around 650 fishermen families, colonies with 650 fishermen, etc., living there. So this is another huge responsibility. So it's a very, very complex issue where you have to basically take care of the science, you have to take care of the environment, you have to take care of the societal needs, you have to take care of the economy of the poor people, and you have to take care of their safety, and then live up to the reputation of your ancestors, what they actually wanted us to do with the environment. And that is where I find that this particular institution has a very, very important role to play, because they are supposed to give us guidelines, they are supposed to motivate the country to manage our course in the most scientific manner, and give good quality, perfect, all-inclusive, thorough, human-friendly also, and environment-friendly also simultaneously plans to the various state governments, because I understand there are at least 9-10 states in the country, and of course places like Port Blair and other islands, where all these issues become very, very relevant. I have been to a number of places all over the world. I remember I went to Mauritius in the early 90s. Then sometimes in 98, for the first time, I saw the beach in Rio de Janeiro. And at other places also, I find that somehow we have to do a lot to actually bring the overall scenario on our coasts and beaches as per international standards. I can tell you that we fortunately have a very, very dynamic Prime Minister. I don't say that because I belong to the cabinet of Narendra Modi. I say that because now I have seen him working from very close quarters over the last 3 years. He is a man with a very progressive approach, very dynamic and innovative thinking, very energetic, very sincere, very honest, very dedicated, and who is always concerned about the welfare of the society and the country, who is always determined to work with his heart and soul to take country to its top, who wants everything in India should be world class. We should be better than the rest of the world. We should be on the top of the world. Our future should be far more glorious than our already glorious past. We all know that India had its richness to its peak. We were like world leaders in almost everything. It's not only managing the environment, but in fields like economy also, which is controlled by our Honorable Finance Minister. We enjoyed a GDP of about 32% till almost from 1st century to 17th century. I am a man from the field of medicine, now into science and technology, ocean science. I know that in all these fields, India has always been a world leader. We have always been on top. We have been on top of the world in education, we have been on the top of the world in trade, commerce, industry, art, culture, whatever you can think of, you get into the depth of the ancient wisdom, ancient past of India, you will find yourself to be on the top. And this is what is the dream of the Prime Minister, that he wants to restore that ancient glory, not only restore that ancient glory, but also to ensure that we are even better in our future than our glorious past. And that is why all his approaches are most modern, most scientific also. I can tell you as a science and technology minister for 2.5 years now, that our Prime Minister haven't studied science officially, but he can give our scientists the best possible vision about how to use science for the welfare of people, how to make science more and more of people-centric, and how to ensure that science is at the rescue, is for the rescue of those issues and problems of the countrymen which have not been yet solved with the help of means in spite of all the things which still remain or which are still awaiting solutions. And you know that a large majority of Indians are still suffering from number of issues. You will be so happy to know that after having come to power, only through science, the information that we provide to our fishermen, the information that we provide to our farmers, our Prime Minister is too dedicated for the welfare of the poor people, for the welfare of the laborers, for the welfare of the downtrodden, for the welfare of the fishermen, those who deserve more attention from us than they have got. The information that our Science and Technology Ministry of Earth Sciences compiles, and we send it only through a small text message to the farmers in various parts of the country. Right now we lend that information to 21 million farmers, and being a Minister of Finance, he'll be able to appreciate that much more than any one of you. This information that our government provides to 21 million farmers through a text message about what's going to happen with the weather, according to which they plan their agricultural moves, farming moves every day, and change them day in and day out, it creates a positive impact of 50,000 crores in the GDP of India. And this is not what a minister of the Narendra Modi government says. It is what the National Council for Applied Economic Research says. And similarly, for the information that we provide to lakhs of fishermen along the coasts in India through various science and technology communication methods also, apart from the text messages about the various, you can say, potential fishing zones and the various issues related to safety, etc. It's another few thousand crores, which is a positive impact.